Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick overview of hostel management system. And this project is developed using two software. First is Visual Studio 2019 for designing and coding, and Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio for database. Okay, let's start with the software. The first thing, this is a login page. As you can see, I have already started the project, and here we have the login page. The first thing, I have set the username btakedays and password is pass. Make sure if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, then please subscribe and hit the bell icon. And for source code, just contact me on Instagram. And here you can see this, when I click on this or when I hover over this, this is a quite good interface. When I click on login, we move to the dashboard, and here you can see this, the dashboard is looking quite nice. Here we have some buttons, that is logout and close button. When I click on this logout, we move to the login. Let me log in quickly and show you remaining features. Just sign in, and here you're gonna see the first thing is manage room. So in hostel we have room. The first thing we have to manage rooms. Here we, when I click on this, see a interface like this, and here first thing we have add room. Here you can see this, I have already added few rooms, 101, 102, 103. I can add 200, 200, and what is this active or deactive? It means that if this one is checked, it means that the room is active. Here you can see this room status. If the room status is not active, it means that you cannot allot that room. It means room is either under construction or we have some work in this. So I'm going to add this room for now, and I'm going to deactivate this for now. Just click on this and room added. When I click on OK, here you can see 200, room status is no and booked is no. And let me close this. Before updating, let me show you a few stuff. When I click on this new student, and here you can see this, when I click on this, you cannot find 200 because that room status for 200 is none. No, it means that that room is not active for allotment. Let me change that and update that. Click on this, and we have to search which room we have to update. We have to update 200 and search for that room found. What happened if we enter wrong room over here? So here you can see this, when I click like this and search for this, no room exists. You cannot update this room. So I'm going to search for this, or let me just click on this and see what happens. It is updated, that is the stuff which shown. Click on this, room found, and when I click on this and click on update, details updated, click on OK, and here you can see this room status is now yes. And what happened when I go over here and now search for room, here you can see this, we have 200 over here. Next thing what I have to do is, I have to delete, we can delete the rooms as well. So I'm going to delete 103 for now, 103, and click on delete. Trying to delete which doesn't exist. Okay, sorry, I haven't clicked on this search button. When I click on this, room found and delete, room details deleted, and click on OK, here you can see this 103 is deleted. And if you search like this, search, no room exists, and when you click on this, trying to delete which doesn't exist. This is a good interface and seems so nice. Okay, click on this and let me close this. Now we move to the new student. When you click on this, here you find a user interface like this. Here you have to enter mobile number and few of the details which are mandatory. So I'm going to enter with the mobile number first, 5566. Okay, 445566. After this, let me add some Rohan as a name, and father name Kumar, father name Kumari, email ID rohan@gmail.com, permanent address India, college name ABC College, ID proof like this. I'm going to give random ID. Okay, and I'm going to allot the new room in which that is 200, and click on save. Student registration successful. I'll click on OK. When you click on OK, every data is clear. You can manually clear the data. Suppose you have filled the data and you don't want to register that student, in that case you can type, click on this button, that is clear, every data will be removed. So let me close this. Update and delete student. When you click on this and mobile number, you can search by mobile number, because for every student mobile number will be unique. 445566, that is the mobile number we have given to the Rohan, and when you search for that, here you can see this, now Rohan is over here. Let me update his name, Rohan, to Rohan Kumar, and just click on update, data updation successful. Now I clear and again search for 4455 and 66 and click on this and hit the status. Now the name is Rohan. When I type something wrong, when we enter something wrong, what happened? Let me show you. Here you can see this, I have added 5 in the last that doesn't exist in their mobile number. When I click on this, every data will be cleared if the data is wrong. Okay, in the same way you can delete any record. So let me click and let me add new student. And here you can see this, we have actually plotted room number 200. That's why the booked status is yes. Okay, we cannot allot 200 again. Here you can see this in the room number, we can't find 200 over here. Okay, here you can see this, now I'm going to add a new student and I'm going to delete that. Okay, I'm going to add random data in this. Sorry, mother name. Okay, so I'm going to add something, Kumari and pdf@gmail.com, India, college name, ABC college, ID proof, like this, and I'm going to allot this 1100 and save, successful, close this, and 100 is also now booked. And let me click on this and search for 44. Sorry, I forgot the room number, mobile number actually. Okay, so what the mobile number is 112233, I guess, right? Okay, so that's the not mobile number. Let me check the database. We have to just click on this and let me search for 55233, actually, the mobile number is. So 55233 and search for this, and I'm going to delete this one. I did show you what to delete it, asking for the confirmation and click on OK. Now I have searched for this 552233 and I'm going to delete this one. When I click on this and it's asking for the confirmation, when I click on OK, student record deleted. Now when you search for 552233 and search, nothing will be found. And you can manually clear the data for each of these stuff. Clear. Here you can see this. Clear. When you delete that record, that room will booked status will be changed to no. Okay, after this, here you can observe we have the fees, student fees. We can submit the fees for that particular student. So our details for the student is 4455 and 66. Search for this Rohan Kumar, and here you can see this for the others, this student haven't paid any amount. Let me pay 5000 for this 5000 and click on pay, fees paid, and close this. And when you click on again and you can search for 445566, search for this, and you can observe that now we have some data inside this data grid view, that is 445566, August 2020, 5000 paid. If you try to again pay some amount for August or same month, no dues of August 2020 left. You have to just change the date, like either for the future or past. You can, that date doesn't matter over here because we have to just pay for that particular month. So September 2020 and I want to pay 6000 this time. Click on pay, fees paid. Yeah, that's work fine. And when you search for this, and here you can see this, now for September the fees is already paid, and you try to again pay something like 60000, no deals of September 2020 left. Yeah, this one is working fine. Here you can observe you cannot pay same month rent again and again. Okay, next thing, we have all student living. So Rohan Kumar is still in our hostel because its living status is yes, and room number 200 is already booked. Okay, that's why all the details for the student who are in the hostel will be visible over here, and all student who left our hostel is over here. So let me change this one, click on this, and mobile number for Rohan is, click that, 445566, click on this 445566 and search for this, and living status is yes. And if I change this one to no and update and click on OK, clear this, close this and move back over here. All student living, no student is living right now. Click on this. Yeah, Rohan is over here because he has left the hostel. Let me change that status to back, living status to yes. On this, yeah. After this, we have new employee. Here you can register new employee, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, name is something Kumar, Kumar Rahul, and something Kumari, Kumar at the rate gmail.com, permanent address India, unique ID, and designation hospital in charge, account manager, Yasik. Employee registration successful and it's already cleared, but you can clear this button too. And now our employee registration is now done. Here you can see this. In this, you can update the detail for the registered employee, like 1234567. For now, we have registered Kumar Rahul. We can update the name to Kumar Bank or Kumar something Anil. And update this one, okay. And working status is yes, that's why we can see these all employee working in this. We can find this Kumar Anil, and let me close this and move back over here. And here you can see this, we have Kumar Anil working in status, okay. And leave him for employee, you can see Rohan Kumar, Raj, Neha, this father name, mother name, email ID, address, ID, designation, working, no. And you can update and delete all of these stuff details over here, like 1234567. I have shown you that update will work perfectly fine, and you can same you can delete the data for 1234567. Okay, so I'm not going to delete this one now because I have to just pay this amount, something like salary employee payment. We have to 1234567. Suppose that you worked for August 2020 and you have to just pay the certain amount, like I have to pay 5,000, and when you click on pay salary for month August 2020 paid, click on OK search, and here you can see this, we have search for this. If you try to pay this again, payment of August 2020 is done, and if you can, you can clear with this button as well, you can clear all the record over here, and this one is working fine. After this, all employee working, here you can see the detail for all the employee working, and in the leave to student, here you can see this, the employee who have left working in our hostel, the data of those will be visible over here. So that's it for this video, guys. I'm going to design and detailed video, I'm going to explain each of these stuff. So just stay tuned and just be with me. I'm going to design everything in this, you can see. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching, and please share and subscribe.